Fire! Welcome! Well, if you cast your mind back to about 3 months ago, maybe even a little more now, feels like longer, but that's how life is right now. Just one long drag. Oh dear. Anyway, let's keep this upbeat. But about 3 months ago, maybe nearly 4 months ago, hopefully most of you would have seen me unbox some really interesting and different kind of figurines here. As you know, our focus when it comes to collectibles, predominantly on Funko products, pops mainly, sodas as well, and other bits and bobs in the Funko genre that I have purchased for my collection. But some months ago, I came across a site called Big Chief Studios, a British site who make collectibles and they do action figures as well. They do them for a lot of different properties. You know, your typically British ones like Doctor Who, Peaky Blinders, Mr. Bean. They do some bobbleheads for him. I purchased the Series 1 set of mini bobbleheads for Only Fools and Horses, Del Boy, Rodney and Uncle Albert Trotter. Really nice items there. I'll leave a link to that video at the top of the description so you can check that out and check out Big Chief Studios if you never saw it the first time round. My one complaint with those, and it wasn't really a complaint because I kind of half expected it, and they are classed as mini bobbleheads rather than full size ones, but they're quite small, but they're made to a cost. You know, this is a small British company. They haven't got the reach and the financial clout of a Funko or anyone else of that size. But they're getting these licenses for British properties. And they also, I think, are one of the Hot Toys stockists for certain Marvel and DC statues as well. So I urge you to go and check out Big Chief Studios. I'll leave a link for their site again in the description too. But please have a look at my Only Fools and Horses mini bobblehead video. And I said there was another Series 1 sitcom set of mini bobbleheads that I wanted. Haven't pulled the trigger on them until today. And that's what this box is. Some of you might be able to remember which set I referred to in the last video that I wanted to get. Also, with the Only Fools and Horses ones, there is a Series 2 supposedly coming out with 3 more mini bobbleheads. That'll be Boise, Trigger and Grandad, but they're still up for pre-order. I think there might be some delay with manufacture, possibly. So you can pre-order them still at Big Chief, but they're not in stock yet. But this Series 1 for a different show is in stock, so let me open it and we'll have a look at them. So this purchase cost me, I think it was £45.99, around £40 for 4 figures. So this series, there's actually 4 figures in this, and then about £6 in postage. And they've not taken very long to come at all either. There's a bit of a delay with the Only Fools and Horses set I bought last year because the Del Boy figure had only just come back into stock. And I think everyone who was waiting for him to come back in had ordered him, and they were sort of taking the time making sure everyone was getting their order sent out. This is a really nice set that attracted me when I first saw it on the site. Just double checking that we've got 4 figures in here. Oh, now that's nice. We've got it's a bit out of date now, but it's a Christmas catalogue. I didn't get a catalogue sent last time, but that's going to be nice to flick through. Really happy to get that, actually. Just make a change from browsing websites. Should be one more figure in there. So 4 figures to show you. I'll hopefully get at least one of them open and then show you that one in a bit more detail, and then the other 3 sort of more promptly. But I'm talking about the Dad's Army Series 1 Big Chief Bobble Buddies mini bobbleheads. They are, and I said this before, as you can see, they're not exactly big. But if you're kind of struggling for display space, which I am, I'm always struggling for display space. You know, theoretically, something this size is going to be easy to display. And I've kept my Only Fools and Horses Bobble Buddies in box because I just really like the design of these boxes with the entire range on the sides here. Nice window display as well. This one is Captain Mannering, of course. Properly licensed. It's got the official Dad's Army logo. There again. They've got a Series 2 coming out. Can't really see which ones it'll be. There again, like the Series 2 Only Fools and Horses Bobble Buddies. They're just still available to pre-order. They're not in stock yet. But let's try and get Captain Mannering out for a better look, and then I'll show you the other 3. Dad's Army. You know how much I love British comedy. I've done videos about my comedy collection and I've mentioned about my love of particularly 70s and 80s comedy, and there's quite a lot in the 90s that I'm into as well. So I'm just trying to carefully get this out, as I like to keep these boxes nice. Don't think this box is sealed. No, it's not. I think I made a bit of a meal of that. So there's a lot of similarities to Funko here, just kind of the box design, although I suppose a lot of collectibles are going to come in this sort of window display type thing. But we've also got the plastic that holds Captain Mannering, originally played by Arthur Lowe in the sitcom that ran from, I think, 1968 it started, and it went on till, I want to say, 1977. There we are. Yeah, small, but really like the design of these. Obviously, they're still very cartoony looking, but they're a lot more realistic looking than Funko Pops, but it's a different product. I was really impressed with the Only Fools and Horses ones, and I've just been waiting a while to order these Dad's Army ones. I think originally I was going to order Series 2 of Only Fools and Horses, and then order both sets of the Dad's Army figures when they came out, but as there's a wait for pre-orders, I thought, you know what, I'm going to get Series 1 of Dad's Army first. That is really nice, that fantastic stuff. Captain Mannering there, the captain of the Warmington-on-Sea platoon. So let's get him back in this bit of plastic here. Head's a bit of an angle, but that doesn't matter. I can sort that out later if I feel like it. So, Captain Mannering, I'll show you the other ones. These aren't going to be in any order particularly, although I suppose it's good that I picked this one up second, because he is second in command. Sergeant Wilson, played by John LeMessurier, looks great. These boxes, I keep saying it, but I think these are really nicely designed. They've got the Bobble Buddies logo on, and the Dad's Army official logo is nice and prominent. And the back of the box is nice as well. These would be really nice to display out of box, but what with them being quite small, they're perfectly easy to display in box, and I think I prefer them that way myself. Your mileage may vary. They do bigger size bobbleheads, by the way, but the only ones I've seen, I think, that are like sort of more, I don't know what size they'll be exactly, probably maybe around a similar size to a proper Funko Pop, maybe slightly smaller. But they do a couple of Laurel and Hardy ones. I do love Laurel and Hardy. I'm very tempted to get those. Obviously, they're more money, and I don't want to quote prices in case I'm misremembering right now. So I urge you to check out the Big Chief's site to check what the prices are, and to also check that they've definitely got the stock in at the moment. Right, next Dad's Army one, 3 of 4. This one is Private Pike. Private Pike, played by Ian Lavender. Dad's Army, just, I grew up with it. Every time someone mentions Dad's Army, I just kind of think back to Saturday evenings after having tea at my grandparents, just us all there, just watching Dad's Army and all of us laughing along. You know, what could be a better memory than that? Just a nice, warm family memory, watching just something that made everyone laugh. There was no one sat in the room, and it was often usually a big family gathering at my grandparents as well. Most Saturdays, there was no one in the room who didn't enjoy Dad's Army. So there we are, Private Pike there. And last but not least should be Corporal Jones. I'm just going to put Pike down there so that he doesn't tumble. So yeah, here's Corporal Jones, played by Clive Dunn. Famously was made up to look a lot older than he really was. I think Clive Dunn was only in his early or mid-40s when he started playing a guy who, I think, in Corporal Jones's case, was supposedly about in his 80s at least, I think. But the butcher, Lance Corporal Jones there, absolutely marvellous. So happy with this set. Something a little bit different to Funko Pops that you do see quite a lot of on this channel. A set of 4 Dad's Army mini bobbleheads there. Corporal Jones, Private Pike, Sergeant Wilson, and the man in charge, the pompous but yet quite brave in his way, Captain Mannering. Awesome set there. Many thanks to Big Chief Studios for prompt dispatch. All of these obviously were in stock right away, so no need to wait around. Still hoping that I'm going to pick up that Series 2 of Only Fools and Horses, and also now that I've got Series 1, I want Series 2 of Dad's Army as well. So I'm going to keep checking back at the site, see if there's any kind of movement on the pre-order dates and stuff like that. I want to say thank you to all of you for watching. Special thanks, of course, to my wonderful subscribers and generous patrons. Please see all my usual collectible referral links, discount codes and the like down in the description text box. There's also an affiliate link for contents insurance at Urban Jungle, and there's my Patreon link and Facebook group link down there as well. It's a links mania, baby. I'm going to go now. I'm going to find somewhere nice near my Only Fools and Horses bobbleheads. They're all over there somewhere, way out of the shot of the camera, but display my Dad's Army 4-pack. Well, it's not a 4-pack, but an order of 4 figures here, alongside another wonderful British comedy collection in Only Fools and Horses there. And I do hope that all of you will join the Warmington-on-Sea platoon and I next time for my next Bobblehead Bobble Buddies collectibles unboxing. Cheers, everyone. See ya!